very, very happy to have the chance to lead all the delegations from Hong Kong and Turkey and Indonesia, and of course our team, to come here and to the presentations. I do hope that you will enjoy your stay here, and you will have a very nice day in the center. You know that each group has 10 minutes for their presentations. So I would like to ask you to keep the time. Is it okay? And then we'll be happy to welcome to the group of Hong Kong to start the session. It's
good morning. I'm from Hong Kong Law Foundation College, Hong Kong. We are so excited to share the facts on our topic, natural heritage in Hong Kong. Everyone knows Hong Kong is an international financial city, but not many know that we have 355 online islands in Hong Kong. Today we are going to show you one of the rural areas. In addition to tall buildings, packed commercial area, hustle bustle of the city, Hong Kong is also well equipped with the beauty of nature, Shell Island and Tai O.
I can't wait to share what we have done in the past 5 months. Let's introduce ourselves. I'm Emily, Julia,
Jackie,
Heidi.
We are here to catch a building. Before we start, we would like to introduce our place to call in King Zai Village. It is a maze of wetland full of different kinds of creatures and plants. There are a salt field and a terrace field.
In our project, we try to investigate the relationship between tourism and environmental preservation. We are going to show the importance of promotion to tourism, preserving the natural heritage, and the ways to preserve and improve the natural environment.
To understand more, we have used three methods. Namely, literature review, interview, and field trips. In order to let everyone of you know what we have investigated, let's take a trip to the Yin Zai Village together.
Here is the model of the village. To go to the village, we need to take a small boat.
After 15 minutes, we are located in Yin Zai Village, and the first stop is Village Outlets. Next to the outlets is Natural Kiosk. It provides hackers which are handled by the region. Chinese period in text. The rice cake routine is a special cultural of Hakka people. During festival, every family will miss some rice cake to celebrate.
As we continue our journey, we can catch a glimpse of the Hakka house on the left hand side. Hakka took glass view into the main house and mainly two or three parallel, which are 300 years old. They rely on natural light and ventilation to maintain a comfortable living environment.
Next, we can visit the salt field. They produce salt here. Salt field is regarded as a natural heritage and full of creatures. In the past, producing salt was the income for the villagers. However, this has been affected in recent years.
Look at these pictures. The next spot is mangroves. Mangroves are located in tropical and subtropical coasts. It is a community grouped by a number of species of plants and animals, such as mangrove crab, muskie pie, and oyster.
There are lots of advantages for mangroves. Mangroves provide habitats, breeding sites, and feeding grounds for a large variety of coastal species. They protect the shorelines. The forest of mangroves provides this is an important food for spirits, crabs, and fishes. Most of our mangroves maintain the stability and ecological balance of the coastal and marine ecosystem.
Mangroves are definitely relevant in the sun. In the village, you can see muskipper and mangrove crab. Muskipper is an amphibious fish which can use their wings to walk on land and swim.
For mangrove crabs, they live in the hole in the front to avoid predator and being dry in the sun.
As we walk along, we can
plants everywhere, for example, bamboo. After a hard trip of hiking, we finally at the pavilion at the peak. As you can see, the panoramic sea view and small islands are bright around us.
We can see the trees from here. Let's walk upstairs.
St. Joseph Chapel was built in 1879. The chapel's architecture and design are simple. The front part is Leota, which is in Chinese in its structure. And it is it becomes a reference place since 1875, which is recognized by the UNESCO. And it has become a capital of buildings since 1875 as all religious decisions were made. It developed into a small village where it is expressed.
Next to the church, there is a sufficient to show the culture of the village. There are something necessary, such as the basket and the bamboo for storage, wooden desk and Chinese board.
Well, a great trip has already finished. Let's discuss about the tourism in the village. The village organizes different villagers regularly. They actively promote the website and recommend the running programs to attract tourists and so as to boost the income of the village. Plus, it has sightseeing for to attract tourists. In order to have a better understanding, we have interviewed the leader of the village, Han Zhongyi, a villager and an author.
We mainly asked them the solution to make the village better, the aspect that the government can do the most for the beauty of nature, the tourism, and the differences between past and nowadays.
They actively developed the tourism, such as holding free travel day and cooperate with travel agents.
Yeah, only the effort by the rich is not enough. Many have admired. They urged the government to deal with their basic problem, such as let them have the property rights and freedom, to let them have the power and freedom to make the place better.
Start from the positive side first. We find that the village has put good effort to promote tourism. They have signs for guarding the visitor and old buildings, like over 100 years old church is covered, such that the heritage will be protected. Plus, it has a Hakka culture has preserved well due to the exhibition. Plus, the church is rebuilt, that's the old appearance from the image of the village. The village provides a wide range of diversity to meet.
Yet, still have new things need to improve. We observe that the road has been damaged, since like the government hasn't maintained for long. So we suggest the government to subsidize the village to check and repair frequently as time goes by. Then we observe that the rubbish is a lot of rubbish is everywhere. And we barely found one or two rubbish bins in the village. So it is suggested to put more rubbish bins at the barbecue area to try to protect the environment effectively.
Currently, the sea is in very bad condition. It is very polluted, as you can see in the picture. The government should clean the sea in order to protect the environment and promote compost image towards preserving the nature.
One of the special chapons in the village is the sawfly. It looks terribly dirty, but it's the habitat of some organism, like a skipper. In order to have a better sight of here, the villager should use the sawfly.
Lastly, some trees are being cut because they said the tree branches are sharp enough to hurt the tourists. Therefore, great balance between tourism and nature is important, which can be improved by finding professionals to replant the trees.
Now I'm going to talk about some suggestions which the government should do for the village. Firstly, the tunnel beside the pier is broken. And it is suggested to building more toilets and repair the old one in order to make it more convenient to the tourists.
There is only one museum in the village. Some houses even have old furniture. You think that it would be workable to convert some of the
out to the world.
This is the end of our presentation. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your very impressive presentation. We all enjoyed, I really enjoyed this profound presentation about this rural part of Hong Kong. And thank you very much for your suggestions. Who did you approach to give your suggestions?
We mainly asked the village leader, Chen Zhongyin, and he suggested some suggestions how to make the village better, such as starting the organic farm to make it green the region and also to attract more tourists.